receive about $650 million, and he was informed that the ambassador informed him that we would only give about $525 million. And our ambassador also said, or left a note saying, that he expected, or we expected, France to increase its military budget, and that the French premier objected very strongly to that and said it was inadmissible. Now, I'd like to ask you whether, where you think this leaves the situation. Does it mean that the French would resent the imposition of conditions by us, or does it simply mean that they resented this particular condition?
I think it's one of those difficulties which happened between the best friends. There was a difference of opinion on the question of the importance of the American help to the French budget, as you rightly said, and also maybe a difference of opinion about the conditions in which such help would be given. But I'm confident it will be straightened out by through negotiations, both in Paris and in Washington. Many difficulties of the same kind in the past were finally straightened out, and fairly easily.
I don't think this is inherent in the situation, that there's a real dilemma here, that if we don't put conditions on our aid to foreign countries, then the money may be wasted from our point. But if we do put on conditions, then the conditions are resented. Now, that's always seemed to me a dilemma. Does it seem so to you?
No, the dilemmas in that matter are never so clear-cut as that. I think there are so many ways to see that the American help is well employed. And I think you have had many testimonies in the past by American authorities that it had been well employed. There are conditions arranged in advance. And I don't think that there was ever any attempt in France to evade those conditions.
Well,
it's a question of argument through negotiations, you know.
Mr. Ambassador, France, like the United States, is fighting our enemy on two fronts. You're trying to prepare in France and Europe, and you're also carrying on a war in China.
Yes.
And just as we are in Korea. Now, for how long has France been fighting in Indochina?
7 years now, seven long years.
And how many Frenchmen are engaged in the war in Indochina?
We, in fact, France has to support in Indochina armies which amount to nearly 400,000 men.
These are native troops or Frenchmen, or what are the proportions?
Both. There are troops from France, troops from the French Union, from Africa, and native troops from the from Vietnam, from the three associated states of Indochina.
And is this a very expensive war to France?
It's a very expensive war, first in human lives. Unfortunately, we have had nearly 40,000 people killed, missing in Indochina.
And how is that war going now, sir?
Well, you saw in the papers yesterday that the Viet Minh, the communists, have started an offensive now, and they have had a first success, which I hope is not a very important one.
Now, that war is, like our own Korean War, is quite unpopular in France.
It is an unpopular war because it's a very heavy burden for France, both in human lives, as I said, and in money. Yes. But it is realized that it's the way to stop communism in the Far East.
Well, here in our own country, we are trying to find ways to end the war in Korea. Does France have any hope of ending the war soon in Indochina?
We are doing our best. We are hoping that the sincere nationalists in Vietnam, in Indochina, will desert the camp of Ho Chi Minh, of the communists, and come to the camp of Bao Dai, and we are organizing a Vietnamese army.
Well, one
last question. Any evidence, Mr. Ambassador, that the Russians are supplying them with equipment, or that the Chinese communists are supplying them with equipment?
No doubt about it. The heavy equipment they have, the recoilless guns and mortars, and guns and shells, all that comes from other lands. They are unable to manufacture anything but very light weapons or ammunition.
Well,
it comes from China.
Here in our own country, we are talking a great deal about the possibilities of being able to train the South Koreans so that Asiatics can oppose Asiatics. What success has France had in training the native troops in Indochina?
Real success. We have now six divisions of the Vietnamese army, plus smaller Cambodian and Laotian armies, fully trained, good soldiers, good young officers. But it takes time. It takes time, of course.
Well, one other thing I'm sure that some of our viewers would like your view on. In America, there has been some feeling that in Indochina, we are being handicapped a bit by some of the hangover French colonialism. Now, sir, are the French in Indochina fighting for the independence of the native peoples, or are you fighting to hold a colony?
We are fighting for the independence, for preserving the independence of the native people, for preventing them to fall under the Bolshevik yoke. They have received their full independence. They are independent now. Unfortunately, they are not still able to protect themselves from that independence.
Well, you contend then that France is fighting the same sort of war in Indochina that we are in Korea, that we're both trying to free peoples from the communist
menace. And it's as costly a war in every respect.
Well, Mr. Ambassador, I wish you could throw some light for us on this thing called neutralism in France.
Yes.
What is neutralism, what do they feel, and how many people feel it?
I'll answer first about how many people. Very few people, very few people. It's the fact of very limited circles in Paris. There is no party in the French Parliament, no group. And you know we have various groups and several groups. There is no group which is called neutralist, no group which pretends to be neutralist. In fact, I don't think there are any members of the French Parliament who are neutralists.
Well, there's a good deal of neutralist sentiment in the French press, isn't there, that finds expression in the French press?
Not much, not much.
Well, now, the neutralists feel, more or less, that here are two giant imperialisms against each other, the Russians on the one side and the Americans on the other, and that it would be better for France to let these two imperialisms fight each other and to sit it out while this fight goes on. Isn't that more or less the neutralist position?
I don't know. I'm not very competent for defining the neutralist position, you know. And I think it's it varies with individuals, and it's more vague than you said. Some of them probably would like to see France using her influence for preventing a clash or diplomatic difficulties between the two camps, including even France, fortunately, in the camp of the free people. It's something which is not very well defined, as I told you.
Mr. Ambassador, of course, France is a traditional great friend of America. It goes back to your helping us in our revolution.
Thank you.
And of course, a great many Americans have fought on French soil in the last two world wars. Now, sir, what about anti-Americanism? Are there any Frenchmen today who are hating America as the Russians want them to?
I think all that comes from the Bolshevik communist propaganda. There is no other source, you know.
Well, is communism on the decline now in France, in your opinion?
I think so.
Well, what evidence is there, in your opinion?
Well, an evidence, for instance, in the fact that the big communist newspaper, the Humanité, you know, had 2 or 3 years ago 600,000 circulation, and now less than 200,000. The fact that during the last elections, they lost half a million votes, and it was at a time when the prices were very high, the wages were low. It was really a favorable period for them. Nevertheless, they lost. So, and since then, we are convinced that they have still lost more votes than that.
Have they been able to make any trouble on the labor front?
They are unable to make a real political, any political trouble now.
As a final question, Mr. Ambassador, I'm sure that our viewers would like your opinion as to whether we can expect peace, whether you believe that we will have peace in the world during the next few years.
I think we are doing exactly what is needed for having peace. We are making sacrifices, all of us, which are heavy for the American taxpayer, heavy for the French taxpayer, but we are building a strength for the free world which will prevent war and to maintain peace, a peace which will become a lasting one, I hope.
Well, thank you very much for being with us tonight, sir.
The opinions you've heard our speakers express tonight are entirely their own. The editorial board for this edition of the Longines Chronoscope was Mr. William Bradford Huey and Mr. Henry Hazlitt. Our distinguished guest was His Excellency Henri Bonnet, ambassador from France to the United States. Longines watches appeal to particular people, to men and women of discrimination who look for a faultless appearance and performance in a watch, as well as in the other things that they buy. For does solid worth appeal to you too? Then for excellence and elegance, Longines is the only watch in history to win 10 World's Fair grand prizes and 28 gold medals. For accuracy, Longines watches have won countless honors from the world's great government observatories. In a Longines watch, discriminating men and women find faultless appearance and performance. So remember that if you spend $71.50 or more for a watch, you're paying the price of a Longines, and you should insist on getting a Longines, for throughout the world, no other name on a watch means so much as Longines, the world's most honored watch. Premier product of the Longines Whitnor Watch Company since 1866, maker of watches of the highest character. We invite you to join us every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday evening at this same time for the Longines Chronoscope, a television journal of the important issues of the hour. Broadcast on behalf of Longines, the world's most honored watch, and Whitnor, distinguished companion to the world-honored Longines. This is Frank Knight, reminding you that your mark as an American is X on the ballot. Vote for whom you please, but please vote.
Enjoy Arthur Godfrey time, daytimes on the CBS television network.